Good afternoon, friends.
Good afternoon, sir.
I am very happy that today we have one more successful participant with us. He is Mr. Sagar Injal. He is a senior IT professional, completed MBA in finance. Okay, and worked 9 years into various IT company into banking domain. He was supporting basically his company. As we know that today the banking is a IT oriented business. So the many company hire the big MNC IT company, Wipro or Infosys or TCS, to take care to build the new software, new applications, and to handle this application. So 24/7 we enjoy the all apps and internet banking, etc. So he worked 9 years in the banking domain with IT segment. He started his journey into regular pathway classroom training. Then he also enrolled last year in video learning to refresh the concepts and calculation, because he took a sabbatical break in 2015 to complete his MBA. Last year, 2015-16,
yeah,
he completed.
15, 16,
so you can say mid 15 he joined executive MBA in Pune with one good MBA college by taking a sabbatical break, and he completed MBA, and then he decided to complete the certification first. So he started with video learning last year in September-October, okay, and by 16 March, he successfully completed his CFP certification, first attempt with the B grade. So I request Sagar, as you are familiar with the participant, so
yeah.
I request you can share your professional introduction about detail. Second, your journey from CFP aspirant to CFP practitioner. Third, what are the benefits in your personal and professional life? Okay, because we don't see CFP certificate to just as a passing the 5 exam. So what benefit you have derived in personal and professional life? What are the messages to CFP aspirant or your clients you would like to give, or your future plans? So to you.
Good afternoon, friends. My name is Sagar Injal. I have backed my experience of 10 plus years in banking IT. So basically we are handling core IT, means whatever banking softwares are there. So I have a little of product knowledge and all, how the banking functions are work, like fixed deposit, loan and all. So we are in that. So after that, during that tenure, I approached to Keyur Sir regarding the CFP. Then after discussing, I thought it is a good one to enroll for, so I have enrolled as a to complete my CFP. Then I took a break for sabbatical break to complete my MBA in finance. So I completed MBA in finance. After that, last March I have completed my CFP, and now I'm practicing the same. So since I started, so Keyur Sir also telling that once you start learning, you can implement with your colleagues, friends and whatever you know. So at least you get a confidence. Whatever you are learning, at least you implement, and within that any errors come, then you come to me so I can solve that. So at least you know that whatever you are learning, it is possible to implement on your friends and all. So I'm doing that also. So currently I have started implementing professionally. So I approach my clients and all. So I want to know their thought process about what they have done till it, and what I can contribute qualitatively in that. So that differentiate we can make as a CFP. So about the practicing and part, means what kind of challenges are there as if you are start practicing, is that once you approach the client, so first you have to make them believe that you as a CFP, you can differentiate in their goals and their finances. And currently in India, means whatever I have seen, that each and every client, means out of 10, at least you 8 client you get, that their thought process is that the insurance is an investment process. Means insurance is a investment only, so they focus more on LIC. And if we start telling apart from that, like mutual funds and each other various kinds of product, so they start arguing that it is a market related, it is a risk, so how can I believe that? So along with that also, if we tell them that there are past performance like 10 year, 15 year, so they tell you one question, that jo ho gaya wo ho gaya. आगे आप कैसे हमको भरोसा दिलाओगे कि मुझे इतना ही मिलेगा? बिकॉज पिछला वॉट एवर हैपन्ड पास्ट, एवरी वन कैन कम एंड टेल अस, बट how you feel confident that ke aage ja ke mere ko at same rate pe I'll gain. So in that I learned that don't over promise or don't tell that ke aap ameer banoge or something. Means make it surely clearly that ke whatever their basic goals are there, we can fulfill with a normal return, and whatever we are Keyur Sir told that then we have to take normal return, don't over promise or overestimate each and everything. So based on that, you know, you can implement one by one, so they start believing in you, and then you can further enhance that, take the fees, and then you can show the correct plan to them and all. So in within that also you can get each and every kind of people. There are singles are there, married, there are people with higher income bracket, lower income bracket. So it's like I will treat that as an opportunity, so you can get each and every area to, you know, perform that. How you plan for the people who are lower income group, but they have various kinds of goal and responsibilities to fulfill. So you have to tell them the proper plan, how we go. Then there are various principles. The whatever we are learning, each and everything will you get the chance to implement, like increasing SIP. Then there are in between you have to pay lump sum and all. So each and every plan, but within that also you have to very clear about your principles, knowledge, and whatever you have learned, because within 5 to 10 minutes if you have jumbled up, then he will not believe in you. He will tell, we will discuss on next time, so give us a time. So we'll never call you again. So you have to be very confident, make your basics very clear, practice it 10-20 as much you want. So in that also, so you will get confident, good confidence, and then you go and implement with your client. So there are kind of things you have to consider, because various time happen that inconfident, we are not brushing up or whatever we have learned. So sometimes happen that you go to client, might be he know the various tricky things, and he will ask you the same thing, and you will jumble up, then your whole that conversation will get lost. So that also things we have to remind. And then each and every client you have to tell them the cost of delay. Means I am sharing one of my recent experience, that one of my friend just I draw his financial plan. So he is UK for last 6 years. So he thought that means here the problem is absence of knowledge. Means there's a cost of delay. If certain things you know and you're not eager to learn that, so you will lost very highly. So I draw their plan. So in last 6 years he has a higher income bracket. So whatever he earned, he is put it in his bank account. So he paying higher tax. So I draw just plan the cost of delay. So in that cost of delay, he has lost the one house. Means if you plan well 5 years ago properly, which if he hire a certified financial planner, do a proper financial planning, then he can afford 1 BHK in Andheri proper. But now he has lost because we don't know anything. So all the amount in lakhs is in bank only. So that kind of things you have to tell the client, that what is the cost of delay, what we can do. So at least the client will gain the confidence in you, and then he will start further that he is accept the your whatever your knowledge and all service, and then he will pay the fee for you, and he will enroll for the financial planning and all. So that kind of experiences I have right till date.
Good, very good. So I request participant, any questions reference to CFP curriculum, about to client acquisition, because this time we are not keeping our training limited to the CFP certificate, I mean to pass the exam 5 with A grade, but our objective is to parallel learn client acquisition, advisory and retention skills. So it is known as a master in family financial wellness planning. Okay, so Sagar has a good experience. He started implementing all these skills since last 2 years to their friends, colleague, relative. So if any questions, you can ask.
How do you interact with
retired?
Have you interacted ever with a retired person?
One retired means not much. One or two retired I have interacted. So if you approach retired enough, so basically their responsibilities are over till that, because if they were son, they married, they are settled. So their first thing is that whatever goals remain. So one or two I retired I have, so they have money, but they know the proper way of knowledge, and they know that much kind of goals and etc. So I told them that go for a vacation, because your finances allowing you to go for a vacation, then enjoy your retired life and if you want to do any social work and all, because there are lots of hobbies. So in retirees, you have to first ask, is your any hobby you have compromised in your younger days? Because what happened that if you have a family, then lots of mother, father compromise their few things because of they thought that the if we have spent on hobbies, there might be there's some we can't able to fulfill our children's
compromising the
previous
goal.
Yeah. So first that things you have to tell the retirees, and then once step by step they open up, then they tell you that this kind of our hobbies are there. So you have to cross check that with the whether that hobbies can we miss, can you afford right now with their finances? If not, so how year it will take. So on basis of that you have to draw the financial plan. So they will help you.
Good, very good innovation, huh? Because you are meeting a retiree and not starting about the asset allocation, not talking about the investments or withdrawal, you are talking about ki helping ke as a you can say retiree, you must have some hobbies and you might not have fulfilled because of the some need-based goal you had in past. So now what are the hobbies you would like to pursue, okay? What is the cost? Help them to pursue the hobby by allowing with the current finance or planning investment, and then achieve after 5 years, helping him to go for a vacation. So that is the first to, I can say, open up the client, create some kind of wow effect. Okay, and then definitely you can go and do routine activities. Yes, any questions?
I have a question. I wanted to ask that how did you approach and strategize for your exam, module exams basically? Because we are after we finish our training, we'll go for module exams after our post training. So I want to know what sort of preparations did you do and what materials apart from sir's materials, if you referred any, because sir's material is enough as everybody claims. But any other material you still refer for more knowledge, something like that?
No, I have not referred any other material. Whatever sir has taught, na, so there are only two things we have to keep in our mind, that five step process and whatever sir has noted down the important principles. These two things must that you have to practice 100 times, it is less, because on that basis, that na, each and every, if even if any twisted question come, na, you go on that process, na, at least you solve that question. So we have to practice first that five step process and that important principles, and then you have to do the important notes whatever sir has given. You have to follow each and every notes and appear as a means prepare, make a preparation as a final exam. Don't go that retirement plan. Suppose if you are retirement planning, don't go in that only select the retirement questions and solve. You have to do that also, but along with that you have to practice all. Because in exam, you don't know which kind of questions come. Maybe some tricky questions come. So you have to be ready with all the knowledge. Then only you can solve the questions. Because don't go specific, like in our college days and all, we skip one question, ki nahi aate, isko side mein rakh do. It is not possible in CFP exam. If some questions come randomly on that only, then you will going to fail. So that you have to practice much. And before appearing exam, at least 1 week before, you have to start give the mock test must. In that, sir will tell you the till what level your preparation is done. If it is required more, so at least you have 1 week, so you can prepare in within that 1 week. Because lot of children do that they give the mock test 2 or 1 day before. So in that, if their preparation is not well, so they will going to fail because they didn't get the time to work on their areas of improvement. Yeah. So that is a must.
Thank you. Okay, my question is that you said there are people who go with the traditional policy even knowing that there are much other benefit policies. So how do you break that myth? I mean, what is your strategy in working that you still, I mean, they avoid basically for start because they avoid, they feel you have to sell product, you make a differentiate still, they feel that LIC is giving them the guaranteed return. So how do you convince them or you talk to them about it?
See, any time if you are going to approach your client, na, within first meeting don't try to explain the product and anything. First or second, take two meetings. Just understand their sense of thoughts about the finance, about their thought process. Because basis on that only you can judge the client whether he is more towards you know, going, he wants to be rich or he wants to be a fulfilled life, that he wants to be rich also and he has to, you know, enjoy the life also. So that first you have to say, because it's like, you know, you have to differentiate with your salesman. Salesmen, they just try to meet the people within 5 minutes. They just take the introduction from client and start explaining their product. Don't do that. First we have to engage with the client, their thought process, what is about the money, what their thought process, their goals. And after that, you have to start, once you engage, you get the sense of that people, and then you just step by step start explaining your product, what is wrong, what is correct. You have to put both the things. Just don't, you know, means what I have learned is that don't tell that LIC is wrong. Tell them LIC is also one of the best, but within that for you, it is not, this thing is not right, this thing is not, it is wrong for you. So tell in that way. If you tell now that LIC is not good and other are good, then they try to, you know, avoid you, because within first meeting you just negative, means just, you know, make them wrong about whatever their thought process is.
You can give a different example, as I thought right now. Okay, suppose you were using 10 years before basic phone, and now there is a smartphone is already there. So which phone you are using right now, basic phone or smartphone? Okay, yes, smartphone. Why? Because there are more features are there, okay, and it is easy to use as per the my requirement. So that's how the product was launched 50 years before, was used to fulfill your basic need. Now your need has multiplied. You can use as a part of diversification, but it cannot be a your only investment, otherwise you may not able to achieve the your additional level. 50 years before, people used to never travel once in a lifetime also. So in a village they brought up, in the same village they may die without traveling to another village. Yesterday I called Nupur at 8 o'clock after receiving some SMS she usually sent in one broadcast list. I called Nupur, you need to come. Sir, I am in US. Oh, so thanks to the WhatsApp, one cannot even aware your person varies, because the internet has given a freedom of you have a smartphone, you did not require a local number and you can use, only you require internet connection. So if you are in Wi-Fi zone and you can anywhere and basically communicate any in the world. So if you are using a smartphone, so it is like same thing, okay? We are offering a new generation product. So definitely new generation product will give you a more benefit compared to the old generation products.
Along with that, you know the knowledge of whatever current affairs are there. Means people who are that the LIC is good and mutual funds are wrong. So tell them that what LIC is doing, taking your money, cutting your all the cost, administration cost, policy cost, and whatever remain money remain, they are going to invest in market also.
Yeah, we usually tell this, but what happens is we say, but at least they are giving us a guaranteed return. And a 5 or 6%, at least they have a guaranteed return. And that is a, I understand.
Yeah,
LIC doesn't give you guaranteed return. It is a bonus. It is every year declared.
Yeah.
It is not necessarily fixed. Please understand. We'll discuss in detail the product. It is a bonus they declare based on the every year surplus they have generated, and it is has a no guarantee. But they are again predicting based on past performance. Okay, LIC has given a 5% return in past, so it is expected to continue 5% return or 6% return in future. So it is like a debt mutual fund. LIC is a pure debt mutual fund product with backed by the life insurance. Term plan plus debt mutual fund is equal to traditional LIC plan. Okay, that will learn in product, because right now, any other question, quick reference to the,
Basically in insurance, like in endowment products, we get a maturity value after a certain time. And we as a, like a well-based study, we see that term plan is better because it gives you a higher life coverage and a low cost, low premium cost. So there also when you convey this thing to the client, no, he says no, endowment plan gives me a maturity value at the end. So why should I like invest in, I mean, for term insurance, because term will give me zero return. So that becomes, though the premium is
in
there.
In that you have one just simple option, just take the premium of endowment policy and premium of term insurance, and whatever term insurance is 25 years, and for calculate the whatever, suppose there is a endowment policy,
mm-hmm.
his premium is around 30,000,
mm-hmm.
and term policy is premium just 10,000.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever 20,000 remains, calculate the at 11-12% market return.
Whatever, even PPF is 7.9% or even conservative 6% or return, based on client wish. Okay, so it is equal. We'll take it this objection, and you will learn and master it in products itself. Now Sagar, as you have successfully completed your certification, okay, so now what are your future plans? So where do you see yourself 3 to 5 years?
Means I'm going to same with the same approach. I try to whatever I have means in the last 2 years, whatever people I have approached, make them my client right now. So it will, it's a, in this also we need a patience, because in within a day, within a month, it will not approach you. It's, we have to constant follow up, tell them, means they also, they busy in their work. So it is a long process. Once you approach step by step, at least 15-20 clients you met, then these client also give you the compounding effect that all they refer with you. So it's a long journey. So step by step I'm
probably. Okay, and what is the message? Because there are many of your friend or colleague, relative or potential client will watch this video. So what is the one message you would like to give as an investor reference to financial planning? What
as
mistakes you have identified in broad sense of the average investor? Okay,
broad
and,
sense? Yeah.
And what is the message to correct that mistakes?
Broad sense is that whatever people are here, they are not cross-verifying with the actual realities. That first biggest myth is that insurance is an investment. So first I have to, we have to break that myth that insurance is a pure insurance and investment is a different. Then we have to go on different way, that we have to take insurance also to minimize our risk and go investment to fulfill our dreams. So if you go in both hands with a logical approach, then whatever our dreams, hobbies are, whatever we have planned, our aspirations are going to fulfill in a very proper way.
Good, very good. Any other questions? So thank you very much,
thank you,
Sagar, for coming, sharing your, you can say, thought on the CFP, journey of CFP aspirant to practitioner. Thanks for...